Hello everyone, myself Ms. Shivani Desai. I am working as an assistant professor in Department of Food Engineering at KK Wagh College of Food Technology, Nashik. Today we are going to start the new interesting course, the Post-Harvest and Storage Engineering, which is the central link between grower and consumer, which gives us feedback and monetary returns by the end user, that is consumer. So in today we will discuss the what is mean by post-harvest, then post-harvest technology, importance of post-harvest technology in boosting the agriculture production, then what are the various losses occurred during the post-harvesting stages, then we will discuss the main components of post-harvest industry, objectives of the post-harvest technology, and importance and role of post-harvest technology in agriculture sector. So let us start with the introductory part. First one is a harvesting. Then what is meant by harvest? It is a specific and single deliberate action to separate the foodstuff with or without its non-edible portion from its growth medium. For example, plucking of fruits and vegetables from the plant by using the harvesting tools like cutter or the knife. Or the reaping of cereals by using reaper binder or using combined harvester, in which the harvesting and cleaning action is carrying out simultaneously. Next one is a post-harvest. All the succeeding actions after the harvesting are defined as the post-harvest unit operations, which are started from the time of harvesting up to the preparation of product for the final consumption. So, it is a central link between the producer and the consumer, which also includes the waste utilization in profitable manner. For example, using peel or the seeds, which are the waste material after processing, used in an auxiliary industry to fetch the more prices. You can see in the picture the various unit of post-harvest unit operations. In the first picture, washing, then grading, drying, then screening operation, packaging and distribution. All these unit operations are considered in the post-harvest unit operation, like pre-cooling, waxing, then cleaning, washing, various chemical treatment, trimming, sorting, grading, packaging, curing, transportation, then grading, storage, ripening, distribution. All these activities are considered as a post-harvest unit operation. What is meant by post-harvest technology? The post-harvest technology is an interdisciplinary science and techniques applied to the agriculture commodities after harvest for the purpose of preservation, to preserve its qualitative value, then conservation, to conserve it for a longer period of time, then quality control and enhancement by various unit operations, to increase its value by using value addition during the processing. Then these four operations are carried out during processing, packaging, storage, distribution and marketing to meet the food and nutritional requirements of the consumer in relation to their needs. Consumer perception is most important while producing any product for the marketing. So we have to meet up the food and nutritional requirements of the consumer needs. Then it is a field of technology which is concerned with the study and application of methods to maintain the quality of harvested commodities in order to prevent the losses. The various post-harvest losses occurred during the subsequent stages of post-harvest, like loss in moisture, then causing shrinkage, loss in stored energy like carbohydrates, then greening, loss in germination quality, then various qualitative and quantitative losses occurred during the post-harvest stages. The major cause of spoilage is growth and activity of microorganisms, insects, then action of enzyme, chemical reaction, then physical changes during the processing. So these losses have to be prevented during the post-harvest technology. So it is concerned with the study and application method to prevent these losses. The post-harvest technology is a set of handling practices and applications that protect the quality of fresh commodities from the time of harvesting up to the time of consumption. So, up to the end user, we have to carry out the various unit operations. So, post-harvest technology is a set of handling practices and application from the time of harvesting up to the time of consumption. Post-harvest stimulates or boosts up the agriculture production by the preventive of various post-harvest losses, then improve the nutrition by addition of various nutrients like fiber enrichment, protein enrichment, etc. Then add value to the product. The today's modern world, people are demanding for the nutritional product, so we can improve the product nutrition of the product by various post-harvest operations. Then open up the new marketing opportunities. Once we prepared the product, as per the consumer preparation, the new marketing opportunities can be opened for us. So it will create the new jobs directly and indirectly. Then reduce the poverty and stimulate the growth of economic sector. Post-harvest losses are occurred different stages of value chain. For example, due to lack of pre-cooling, the losses occurred about 10 to 20% because once the harvesting is done, the respiration rate is high because of high temperature and lower humidity. So, pre-cooling is required once the harvesting is done to reduce the temperature and the respiration rate from the fruits and vegetables. Then, lack of proper handling, the losses occurred about 10 to 20% because it creates the impact damage or the various rough handling can causes the cuts or the different damages to the fruits and vegetables during the transportation or the distribution from the producer to the consumer. Then lack of storage facilities can cause up to the 10 to 15% losses because it is a harbor stage to growth of insect and pest which can damage the grains or the reduce its quality during the storage. The post-harvest industry includes various components from the harvesting up to the consumption. For example, harvesting and the threshing, which can combinedly done by the combine harvester or the modern processing equipment. Then cleaning, washing, sorting, grading. These are the first and most important unit operations to reduce the damage to the further processing equipment or to increase the value of the commodities. Then drying and storage. Then processing, packaging, transportation and distribution, material handling, marketing, utilization by consumer, managing or the integration of total supply chain. These all unit operations are included into the post-harvest unit operations, which are carried out to increase the shelf life of the product by various means, by using the various different processing technologies and for storage at refrigeration condition. Then, what are the objective of the post-harvest technology? The first or most important objective of post-harvest technology is to maintain the quality of product, for example, appearance, texture, flavor, nutritive value at affordable cost to the consumer. It is shown that the consumer perception is most important whether to accept the product or to reject the product. So, the processor should have to maintain the quality of product by appearance, then texture should not be hampered during the transportation or the distribution. The product nutrition value should retain up to the long last period. Then to protect the food safety, food should not be hazardous to the consumer. Then to reduce the losses between harvest and consumption. As we have discussed, the various qualitative, quantitative or the physiological losses occurred between the harvesting up to the consumption. So to prevent these losses is the main objective of post-harvest technology. Then to reduce the loss in quantity, that is in volume, then qualitative losses, that is nutritive value of the product, then various physiological losses. Then to increase the shelf life of the crops, as fruits and vegetables have higher respiration rate after harvesting, to increase its shelf life for a longer period of time, it should be stored within the refrigerated condition, and transportation should also in a refrigerated vehicle. So this is included in post-harvest operation or the post-harvest technology. Then to keep the fruits and vegetables or the commodity free from insect pests, especially during the storage condition, because insect and pest attack is mostly occurred during the storage period, when the product is stored for a longer period of time, then it should be keep in mind that insect and pest attack should not be occurred during the storage. Then to get the vegetables and fruit fresh all year the around, as we have the different geographical conditions, fruits and vegetables should be should have to carry out from one location to the another location, so it should be fresh for all year around. Then it helps to effective backward linkage with the farmer for processing their raw produce. Backward linkage is most important in post-harvest processing, because the quality of final product is majorly depend on the quality of initial product. So backward linkage with the farmer for the processing their raw produce, it should be of good quality. Then increased availability of byproduct for further processing. The post-harvest technology not only included the handling of fresh fruits and vegetables, but it also handling the waste utilization, as the large amount of seeds and seeds or the peel created during the processing of fruits and vegetables. So we can prepare the auxiliary industry, we can set up the auxiliary industry to get the nutritive value among these. For example, we can extract the pectin from the peel of apple, which fetched the more prices, which ultimately contributed to the economy. Therefore, the post-harvest technology, which deals with the fresh products, processed product, as well as the waste utilization. Then next one, keeping the product cool to avoid the moisture loss and slow down the undesirable chemical changes. Moisture losses can cause shrinkage of fruits and vegetables because of high temperature and low humidity. So to avoid the moisture loss, the product should be kept in the refrigeration condition. Then next one, avoiding the physical damage such as bruising to cause the delay of spoilage, because physical damage can cause the impact during the transportation and the distribution can cause the spoilage of fruits and vegetables. So post-harvest technology can reduce the losses during the transportation. Let us discuss the importance and role of post-harvest technology in boosting the agriculture production or boosting the agriculture economy. The first one is reduce the post-harvest losses. We can reduce the losses by using optimum harvesting factors or the optimum maturity indices. Or we can reduce the losses during the handling, packaging, transportation and storage by using the modern infrastructure, modern machineries or the refrigerated vehicles. Then processing into the wide variety of products can reduce the losses after harvesting. Then we can use the low cost technology, so the production cost will reduce. Then we can convert the bulky, perishable and inedible food materials into the more useful, then shelf stable and palatable products, which can fetch the more prices in market. Then we can preserve the food material by using different preservation methods, for example thermal processing, low temperature freezing, drying, chemical and biological reactions, or the novel technologies like high pressure processing, irradiation, etc. So reduction of losses is most important role of post harvest technology in agriculture. Then second one is a value addition. As we know that fruits and vegetable preservation industry is a backbone of horticulture industry and it is a rising sector of agriculture economy. So to take care of gluts and waste, we can produce the value added products from the fruits and vegetable or the grains which can fetch the additional income to the growers. So it will help in stabilizing the prices with economic returns. For example, in peak season the excess production is occurred. So we can process them into the various products which can be more valuable in the marketing. Example, suppose tomato, we can convert the tomato into the ketchup, paste, puree and frozen line. So it will be holds the price line in the market and contributed to the economical indication. Then third one is a contribution to the economy. Fruits and vegetable sector or the post harvest unit operations has immense potential to contribute to the economy of nation by industrialization, because processing sector contributes to the employment generation, then it stabilizes the prices by providing the better returns to the farmers, growers or the processor. We can transfer fruits and vegetables into the edible products or the intermediate foodstuff by using scientific knowledge, machinery and the energy. So we can it will contribute to the economy directly or indirectly. Then fourth one is a making availability of fruits and vegetables during the off season, because steady food supply throughout the year can influence the price structure. It will balance the supply across the regions in the India. We can formulate and design the foods by taking into consideration the consumer preferences, then distributor demand, ingredients availability, the scientific knowledge of properties of material being processed or being distributed, then profitability of the particular processing unit, then technical feasibility of particular project. We can convert the fruits and vegetables into various products which can be used during the off season. Then fourth one is it is a tool for foreign earning, because to earn the valuable foreign exchange is a major spin-off benefit of the food industry. In foreign countries, the preserved fruits and vegetables are highly demanding. For example, juices, nectars, juice concentrate, canned products or the dehydrated vegetables have rising demand in foreign countries. So it is very useful tool for the foreign earning. Then employment generation. All the food distribution stages generate jobs directly or the indirectly, right from the harvesting up to the consumption. The number of people are working in the food industry. For example, direct employment generation includes the processors, the employee of services, then security, cleaners, design engineers, then accounting. These all are included in the direct employment generation. Then indirect employment generation contributed to the transportation facilitators, then raw material suppliers, packaging material, machinery, ingredient suppliers, etc. So processing industry has tremendous job opportunities. It will contribute to the employment generation. Then adding the variety in taste and nutrition, because taste as well as nutrition is required in today's fast-paced world. Especially urban people are demanding more cooked or ready to eat or ready to cook products, because they don't have time to cook the delicious items. So ready to cook products, special attention for the children, infants and women are highly demanding in the market. So we can add taste, variety and nutrition into the particular product by enrichment by the waste material. For example, fiber enrichment, then protein enrichment, which can fetch the more prices in market. Then waste utilization. As I already discussed, the waste utilization can set up auxiliary industries. For example, we can extract the pectin from the peel of apple, which can fetch more prices and helps processor to fetch the more prices or stabilize the economy of the particular processing unit. Then home scale preservation. It should be the integral part of education because home scale preservation can reduce the losses. For example, preparation of pickles, jams or the chutneys at home scale can reduce the losses and also can get back the money. So to conserve every ounce of surplus fruits and vegetables right from the home scale should be preserved, because someone rightly said that an ounce of practice is better than tons of theory. So home scale preservation should be the integral part of food supply chain. Then vital supplier to the defense forces. To meet the need of particular mission, we can prepare the ready to food material which can be carried with them at different heights and altitudes, which are mostly lightweight, so they can carry with them and also which can provide the greater energy for them. So it should be a vital supplier for the defense forces. Then special canned fruits and vegetables for infants and children. We can prepare the products according to the age group or the different food choices, according to the consumer perception or the consumer preferences, because children of small ages are preferring more sweet items or different nutritional products are required for their growth. So special canned fruits can be prepared for them. It is a great field of vigorous activity, so we can prepare the child feeding material, etc. Then food supplier to the astronauts. The person traveling into the spacecraft needs special kind of food, so we can prepare the food keeping in view their mission requirements and the condition in the spacecraft. So it is very interesting and very innovative field to prepare food for the astronauts. So these all are the importance and role of post-harvest technology. So today we discussed what is meant by harvesting, what is meant by post-harvest technology, what are the objectives of post-harvest technology, then its importance and role of post-harvest technology in boosting the agriculture production. So in the next video, we will discuss various unit operations carried out after the harvesting. So thank you one and all.